Welcome to Randy's office. In this episode, we'll look at how to complete a SimNet project. Most of you will start in your course LMS, whether that's Canvas or Blackboard or D2L, and select the project that you're going to complete. And I'm going to select this one here, and that will take you to SimNet, to the project area in SimNet. Once in the SimNet project area, you'll start in the download area where most likely you'll be prompted to open the best practices and read those and acknowledge that you've read those. But what you'll do is you'll start with the start file and you'll click on that and download that start file. And I will do that and save it to my desktop. Also, if there are additional resources, many of the projects have additional resource files, those will be listed right next to the start file. You could also use the file download wizard to download all of the files, the start file, the resource files, the best practices, and a solution file also, which is a PDF of the solution. Once you download your start file, the instructions are on this screen, and this is a little different. This is a new feature in the Office 365 2019 projects, in that the projects are right here on the screen, and your system will automatically detect whether you're using a Windows computer or a Mac computer, and you could toggle between those two, but it'll automatically detect the correct ones to use. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna follow these instructions, and a nice new feature that we've added is a little checkbox by each instruction, so that as you finish an instruction, you can check it and it will move on to the next instruction and highlight that, and you can continue doing that all the way through. So it will track your progress. At any point you could reset your progress, which would take off all the check marks and start back at the top. But a nice feature, and you continue going down, following all the instructions. And when you're doing this, you can, if you want to print these instructions, you could do that also up here. You could also make them larger or smaller. So you have quite a few options. You could split your screen if you want, or if you have multiple screens, you can do it that way. Whatever works best for you in completing these projects. But work through, read the instructions carefully, and complete all those instructions. After you complete all of the instructions in the project, make sure that you save your file. Ideally, save and close your file so that all the most recent changes that you made are saved, and then return to the SimNet area. In the SimNet area, you can upload your file, and I'm going to upload it from the desktop. And then it's going to ask you if you're ready to submit the file now, or if you want to save it and continue working on it later. I'm going to go ahead and submit the file now. If you chose no, I'm not ready, then it will save that file and you could download it later and continue working on it. But I'm going to go ahead and say yes, submit the file. When the file has been submitted, you'll get to this grading area that will show you your grade up here, your score, and then it shows you a couple other things. So it shows you the solution file over here with detailed annotations about what you did correct or partially correct or incorrect. So anything green is correct, anything red is incorrect, and anything blue is partially correct. Over at the left side here, if you want to see all the annotations, you can click on correct where they're all highlighted. See everything. If you want to filter for just things that are partially correct or incorrect, you could deselect that, and that way it shows up only those that are partial or incorrect. I can drill down here and see what's incorrect in there, and it'll tell me what I did and what I need to do on here in the instructions. Same thing over here. All these numbered items relate directly to the instructions in the project. So you can review that. If there's any changes that you need to make, you can go back in and correct your project. Some instructors allow multiple attempts on projects. You could also at any point download your most recent submitted file, or download the solution file here. To return to the project area, you could click on the project up here, and that's going to take you back. So if you make the changes in your project, the corrections, then you can upload your file again. So I'm going to go ahead and do that and submit the file. And this time I got everything correct. So there's my file, or there's the solution file with everything green and all correct. I can go back to the project area And nice thing in the project area is if you click on this previous attempts button, it will take you and show you your previous attempt. So here's my first attempt that I got 86%, and then my second attempt. And I can download those files if I want. If I want to view them again, if I want to go back and look at my first attempt, I can do that and see what I did incorrectly. So that's it. It's a pretty straightforward process, and I hope this was helpful, and I wish you the very best.